of a fun where they choose their players from the DSCV Premiership. Mm-hmm. Some of them. We had, and I hate doing this, but
yeah,
like I really do, guys. But it's not. It's
but
not
it's them, gonna, Chief. It's them.
It's them. It actually it's you. It's not
you.
Us.
It's not us.
It's not us, Brian. But. Eish. Maritzburg College, keep calling them Maritzburg College.
Maritzburg United.
Maritzburg United versus Kaizer Chiefs. Now, to explain this game, it was 1-1.
Yeah.
Maritzburg United are in the relegation zone. Straight
the
up.
Fighting relegation.
They have played 18 games, got 14 points. They shouldn't be there based on this game because they utterly destroyed Kaizer Chiefs. But
Did I not tell you? Did I not say that if Maritzburg United or Ernst Middendorp is Maritzburg United, if they can play Kaizer Chiefs for the next 7 games, they'll get out of the relegation zone.
Yeah, so
because, true. Because, I mean, look, Maritzburg United led the majority of the game, 1-0, went on, and it goes
an
back.
Open goal.
I hate being right and having to remind people that I'm right. Thabiso Kutumela can only do so much.
Yeah.
He cannot score and defend at the same time. He must keep concentration. And they lost the game at the very crucial part of the game, the final 10 minutes. That's when you need to switch up. You cannot lead, rather concede in the 45th minute just after half time and just like play it to 1-0 draw and then that's it. Because now you're already playing this whole game, 80 minutes of running, and in your mind and some players are like, okay, good, this will be a huge boost for us. We're beating Kaizer Chiefs, we are there. And then you're gonna let slip of a lead such that is so fragile. Right at the death. I know, man.
Yeah, like, and that's what I said, because I know that for Maritzburg United, that their next two games are against their relegation rivals. Like, I know one of them is cheap, but the next three of their next four, they're facing teams 3 points
above them. Yeah.
So they can get out of it, because the way they played, they actually played football. Kaizer Chiefs could not hold on to the ball for rocks. They were doing. I told you about that Marco Polo. They were literally
Marco!
Still. Exactly. We hate being right. But they were literally closing their eyes and being like, I can't. I'm not going to pass to anybody. Oh, no screams. They're like, yeah, shut up. I'm going to pass to them. That's the only way that they could communicate. I can say Mignana was the only player that actually tried. In the second half, Gavin Hunt tried to make him, like, gave him more space to, like, operate.
Be mobile.
But the rest of the team, I can't say anything positive. I really hope that you guys can make top 8 so you can qualify for the MTN 8.
Yeah, man.
But that's pretty much it, and hope you do well in CAF. Like, that's pretty much it.
But remember what I said. Yeah. I said for Kaizer Chiefs for the rest of the season, a point for them is victory.
Point for them is
because
victory.
Because of the reason that I've stated before. Because I think the whole slump of them, it's beyond tactical. It's not, I don't think Kevin Hunt is that much of a failure for him to not being able to do stuff like that. He has players that are dealing with a lot mentally of how they lost the league. That is my point. You can tell me if I'm wrong or right, but it's beyond that. And they're playing against, it's very dangerous to play against a relegation team.
Because they have nothing to lose.
They throw everything forward. And they when they lose, like, another game you lost. It's very difficult because they're always trying to bring their A game. They're fighting for survival. It's very difficult. And it's going to be tricky. Unfortunately for Maritzburg United, it's going to be tricky. You playing against your relegation candidates or candidates of relegation, and they also want to get one over because a victory for them moves them a spot up higher or moves them just away from the relegation zone, and it's going to be tricky for them. But they can take a lot of things, good positive things. Between the first and the 80th minute, they played really well. They organized themselves well. Yes, they let Kaizer Chiefs a few spaces here and there, but they were compact. They were able to play and they were able to score a goal and be able to maintain for the 80 minutes. If they can take that performance prior to them conceding and translate it to other games, they will survive if they do something like that. You know, you remember that you obviously you are playing for survival.
Yeah.
You don't play, you don't go there to play beautiful football. You don't go and try and play some total football and try and offside traps and try to be fancy, you know, zonal marking. You don't do that. Even if it means you come in, compose pressure, road one, go there, hit it, Kutumela will do the rest. That should be your strategy. That's not what you should do. You should be doing. It's going to be tricky when they play against the Chipa United side. Chipa is playing really well.
Playing football. And I'm like, as I said, those are going to be some really good games. Like, I think the relegation battle is the most interesting battle to be because the teams at the bottom are the teams that are surprisingly trying to play the best football, which doesn't make sense.
You know,
but like, when they're not getting the results. But like, I think that'll be a very interesting, entertaining game to watch. But a team that was in a relegation battle, but is flying high, sailing in the top eight, AmaZulu, defeating Chippa, our boys, local boys, Benny McCarthy. Yeah. I can't say anything but except, like, well done. Like,
carry carry on. Yeah.
Carry on pushing, but because he's undefeated away from home, I think that he just, and I think this is what coaching, good coaching does do, because it's the same players,
but just then different,
just different
person to help. Yeah.
And I'm happy for our boys.
Definitely.
Like, coming back from being relegated to now being strong. Powerful stuff, man.
Definitely. And also a quick shout out to Golden Arrows too, sitting secondly at the top. But obviously we I'm saying second right now. We'll never know what's going to happen, because you know this thing is a weekly podcast, né? So there's a lot of things that happen in the space of a week, but as we are speaking right now, they're second. But it's going to be great. So yeah, it should be an exciting couple of weeks.
Yeah, no, so we've gone from the African continent. Let's head a plane and a visa to the